So this bathroom we're looking at, it's a renovated bathroom in Atlanta. What was the existing bathroom like?
The existing bath was an interesting 1960s renovation. The house itself was a historic house from the early 20th century, the early 1900s, and a beautiful historic home that obviously didn't have the kinds of bathroom spaces that we would consider to be comfortable today. Bathrooms were much, much smaller in that era. So it had been made a little bit larger and been renovated in the 1960s, but I would say in a very haphazard way. And it certainly didn't meet up with today's aesthetic standards. So it was in some disrepair, and in addition to it just not being very attractive.
One of the interesting things I think in the design is the vanity. How did that evolve?
Well, that was pretty specific. The plumbing was in an existing location that worked in general for the size and shape of the bathroom at the vanity location. It originally was only one sink, and the client obviously in their master bath wanted to have two sinks. But the way the bathroom was arranged, if we'd done a typical rectangular vanity that had cabinetry all the way to the floor, it would have intersected with the shower enclosure in the tub in a very awkward way. It would have just kind of slammed into the side of it in a way that wasn't very attractive or functional for getting in and out of the shower. So what we did was we created a kind of a curved edge shape that softened the sides of the vanity and brought it back to the wall in a very traditional shaped way. It was not in a contemporary way. It's called an OG edge, the shape. And it tucked the vanity back to the wall in a very kind of neat way, so it didn't slam into the side of the shower enclosure. And opening up the bottom of it was something that sort of evolved. Everybody wants extra storage in their master bath, but the floor space was so tight, the depth of the bathroom was not really sufficient for it to be comfortable. So by opening up the bottom of the vanity and sacrificing that storage, actually relocating it to a different location, helped the floor space feel a little bit more ample and comfortable. And we do have the center stack of storage right down the middle in between the two sinks, but by creating that knee space up under the sink area was just to visually open up the bathroom experience and making it feel less crowded.
The other thing that's interesting is the way that you use drapes in this bathroom. How did that come about and what do you use them for?
Well, that was kind of another one of those, here we have an issue, how do we solve it, kind of design questions. And of course you need a shower curtain. You don't want the water to spray out all over the bathroom. So creating a shower curtain that aesthetically contributed to the bathroom and not just protected from water spray was our first step. But if you were to do a 180 degree turn from looking at the shower, you were looking towards where the toilet, the commode, is situated. There wasn't enough space in the bathroom to create a private water closet for that. So to create a little bit more privacy, we mirrored the location of the drapery like we had done on the shower side in the direction of the commode. So it is sort of tucked behind a bit of drapery that you can close off. I don't know that they would have occasion to all that often, but it can be made private or more private pretty quickly and easily. And from a design standpoint too, it helped soften the overall effect of the bathroom. You know, we use a lot of hard surfaces in bathrooms, porcelain, stone, mirror. And so to be able to soften that with a little bit of fabric is something that we like to do if we can.